Even I pun takut whether we boleh ke tidak. But again, tanggungjawab kita is to usah. Setapak-setapak pun tak apa. As long as we're moving forward. Keep improving, don't give up. Nama saya Firman bin Fauzi, asal daripada Kelantan. Currently, the official jawatan is the CEO for Chicken Rice Guys lah, CRGs.
Habis college tu, I met this one Chinese guy. Dia duit banyak, masa tak ada. Kita pula masa banyak, duit tak ada. So, he invited me untuk kerja dalam projek biomass dia yang dia baru nak usaha. Then later, I masuk into property investment.
Tercetuhnya minat ke property ni, I think asalnya I think from my father-in-law. When kita baru lepas nikah tu, kita duk cari tempat nak duduk, and he gave us a good price. I think harga market time tu RM150. Dia offer kat kita RM100. So I said okay, Alhamdulillah, terima kasih banyak for the help. So we make arrangement to pay. Tak lama lepas tu, dia fikir, what's next? So itulah, we were looking for a business yang boleh generate cash flow. And then kita ni big believer of following your passion. Kalau you minat doing something tu, and then you can get paid for it, then silakan. So that's why we started CRG jugalah. I think the two main reason asal kenapa we start CRG was satu, nak share the good food. Second, at that time was untuk run it as a business. Menu we sell like Chinese style chicken rice, kita ada roast duck and the itik goreng rempah tadi tu. Everything on the menu are all family favourites lah yang kita dok want to share with you all. I knew we're gonna show you the main process of how kita prepare ayam roasted kita di CRG. Kami kat CRG, we do roasted, 95% roasting, panggang. Lepas tu kita akan habiskan dengan sedikit mandian ingat. First step is, bila ayam segar datang, kita akan pergi ke kawasan basuh untuk pembersihan. Buang all the organ dalaman and whatnot. Ni step kedua, we have to masukkan ayam ke dalam air panas. Buat 3 kali celupan. Ayam yang standard yang kita pakai, yang kita minta is about 2.3 kilos. We also request nak dapat ayam bulat to get a complete skin. Sebab chicken rice ni, the other factor is nak get, kalau Chinese kata, hiong sik mei. Hiong is the wangian of the ni, sik is the colour. So the skin yang akan come out the colour of the chicken, the appearance. Mei is the taste later on. So once your chicken dah habis basuh, the next step is masukkan ke dalam air panas. You nak guna kepanasan air tu untuk shock the skin. You nak kecutkan kulit tu. And then later on, when once you panggang, dia akan jadi lagi garing. Chinese kata siong lok. Pastikan air panas tu masuk betul-betul dalam rongga ayam. Angkat, pastikan semua air yang dalam rongga tu keluar. Then you're ready for the celupan nombor 2. Sampai ini yang you nak cari. You nak rasa kulit dia macam ada dimple, macam ada jerawat-jerawat kat kulit. So you dah hit this tu, insyaAllah dah should be okay. This the third step. Ni kita panggil wet marinate kita. Kita pakai madu dan sedikit tambahan sos manis, soy sauce. So the process, you nak make sure the wet marinate tu cover setiap penjuru ayam. So this one done. Pergi step 4 pula. This is where kita masuk the rempah marinade yang kita akan rub dalam bahagian ayam. This is a mixture of kita punya spice. We are using the cinnamon, clove, cengkeh, Sichuan pepper. And then CRG ada tambah 2-3 rempah lain lagi just to give it a little bit more flavour dan bring out the flavour of the chicken. So what we do is, angkat and taburkan the spice inside. Gently massage bagi setiap permukaan dalaman tu dapat rempah tadi. Bagi dia kena the right amount of salt, sedikit kemanisan, the pepper and the spices. Habis yang ni, to achieve that juicy meat, crunchy skin, kami advise untuk gantung untuk biar dia kering. So what we do habis this process, we just leave it there, air dry, mungkin dalam the best ideal one dalam 4 ke 5 jam lah. I think startnya CRG sebab kita ni besar half Chinese. So kita duk biasa makan ni style Cina dari kecil lagi. I think one of the best chicken rice yang kita, yang personal I pernah makan kat Kota Baru. I remember Pak Sedara pergi parking depan kedai. There's this Chinese mu'alaf pakai baju pagoda dengan topi chef. I remember bila buka tu, the smell of that chicken rice. And then bila you ambil air dia capung nasi, letak dia punya sambal. everything blend well together. If I'm dating with my girlfriend, now bini ni, our go-to place selalu kat chicken rice lah. Dia pun favourite dia chicken rice juga. We used to go to Singapore chicken rice dekat Sarawak. As we grow older ni, nak cari masuk ke nasi ayam yang kita dok biasa makan tu, agak susah. Yang mana hok kita tahu tempat sedap, kita tak boleh makan. Sebab berkali bahan-bahan dia pakai tu tak non-halal dengan preparation non-halal. So itulah we thought, let's buka CRG untuk kongsikan the food yang kita dok biasa makan ni to the taste yang kita dok bersih kami. Dah gantung for 45 minutes. Dia dah ready for the oven. So now proses untuk ayam ni dipanggang. Dah masuk, kita biar oven buat kerja dia. Suhu dia 200 darjah Celsius untuk ayam saiz ni, and timing tadi 45 minit ke 1 jam. So this oven they call it an Apollo oven sebab the function is the gas kat bawah tu dia akan circulate the heat evenly across the chicken. Hence why ni commonly used lah. So now dah habis dah 1 jam. We will check the chicken. This looks like almost 90 ah. Kalau macam ni you nak masak sampai dia 90-95% masak. Then kita finish off dengan last step yang itu mandian minyak. Next step kita pergi bahagian minyak. Is to do the, we call it mandi ayam. So now what we like to do is to ambil minyak panas dan alirkan atas bahu ayam ni. Apa? Atas kepak ayam ni. You nampak tak? Kalau you look closely kan, you boleh nampak reaction of the skin. See, dia macam bubbling dah the skin tu. Minyak sebenarnya you don't need, kita tak perlu banyak sebenarnya. Kalau you nak jimat, you pakai kuali biasa tu dengan minyak, bagi dia panas, pelan-pelan siram. You tak payah celup. Tapi kalau untuk kedai kadang-kadang you need the speed kan. So we use about 3 botol 5 liter punya minyak. 15 liter lah. So you asking me how do you know if the kulit dah garing? You akan nampak dia punya slight gelembung getting ready to be garing. And you nak capai this warmness for seluruh badan ayam. So itu the goal bila do this step. So now tinggal kita gantung, drain dan ready untuk ke depan, dipotong dan dihidang. In starting this, memang akan problem akan datang. We just have to be prepared and pandai maneuver. When you say day one, kita buka CRG ni, kita tak ada knowledge or experience langsung dalam FMB. The physical requirement untuk run pun not easy FMB ni. Everything you kena buat. Which like I said, you look back is good. So susah at that time, tapi you look back, it is, these are the things that make you stronger. That's why now harapan for CRG is actually way bigger. Even I pun takut whether we boleh ke tidak. But again, tanggungjawab kita is to usah. Setapak-setapak pun tak apa. As long as you're moving forward, keep improving, don't give up. Now we have Syarul akan our captain bahagian ayam dan itik belakang ni. Dia akan demo how we do kita punya itik panggang. So step one, again sama, itik sampai kita kena bersih betul-betul, buang segala bahagian dalaman. Pastikan kulit on the duck pun sangat penting. Dia tak boleh ada lubang-lubang. It has to be intact. So step one, dia akan masukkan ginger slices dalam badan itik. Lepas tu kita akan masukkan sedikit bawang putih, bunga lawang. Bergantung saiz lah, kalau itik tu besar, dia masukkan lebih sikit. Ni one of the spices to bagi that flavor again. Number two, dia nak buang hamis daging itik. Dan juga dia akan bantu tenderize the meat. So what it's doing now, macam surgery sikit. Dia akan jahit the opening of the duck. Sebab nanti we will put in some wet marinade. Dan kunci jangan bagi perapan ni keluar daripada badan itik. So now ready untuk masuk kita punya wet marinade untuk itik. So dalam ni we ada letak tauco, soy sauce, pati bijan, madu, dan sedikit oyster sauce. Lepas tu what he's going to do is dia akan masukkan pump untuk memisahkan kulit itik tu daripada badan dia. So you see? So tu penting, kalau you jahit pun kena betul. Kalau tak, angin semua keluar. So selesai proses marinade tadi, pisahkan kulit. Kita akan masuk proses air panas juga, sama macam ayam panggang tadi. Proses ni apa yang kita nak capai, we want to maintain yang marinate tadi dalam, kat dalam, tapi kita nak ketatkan kulit luar lagi bahagian nitik tu. Sekitar 30 saat, 1 minit kot. So, ni dah habis proses tu. Now tinggal gantung dan kering dalam 6 jam ke 1 malam. Once you dah dapat ni, meaning the skin tu dah mula kecut. So, now tinggal dia kering, marinate betul-betul resap dan kita boleh masuk proses panggang. Selepas panggang up to 95% masak, the last process kita finish off dengan minyak. Habis yang tu, dah boleh bawa ke depan untuk dipotong dan dihidang.
We met good people. That's the story yang this Chinese guy yang came makan. After makan tu, he came to look for us, berair air mata, and he said thank you so much. This remind him of arwah mak dia punya masakan nasi ayam. So my point is, CIG is that tapak for me. Kita met good people. We financially pun alhamdulillah kita cukup. Hargailah benda ni and then continue on. When I say we want, our harapan is to continue improving and continue to grow. Dia macam ada pokok buah dekat rumah you. Kalau dekat rumah you, you seorang, you boleh makan dengan orang keliling tu. We thought of having it in multiple places, so orang lain pun boleh dapat manfaat yang sama.
Jemputlah datang ke CRG, Chicken Rice Guys. We are in 3 location. We have one in Shah Alam Section 7, one in SS15 Subang, and the latest baby, adik terbaru di Kelang. You can look us up on kita punya Facebook or Instagram, crgchickenricesguys.com. Jemputlah.